So welcome to this talk about connecting .NET Core to Divas. My name is Tom De Seyn. I work at Red Hat in the .NET Core team. In our team, we package .NET Core for Fedora, OpenShift container platform, and we support our customers with .NET Core issues they have. I'm also a member of Fedora's .NET special interest group, which is an open group for people who are running on Fedora using .NET. So we package .NET Core for Fedora, and we talk about .NET stuff. That group is open to anyone that wants to join it. I'm a contributor to .NET Core, and my contributions are mainly focusing on fixing Linux issues, and I maintain a number of .NET Core Linux-focused libraries, or .NET libraries, like the one I'm giving this talk about, which is for working with Dbus. I think most of you know Dbus, but in case you don't, this is a one slide overview. So Dbus is an IPC mechanism, so inter-process communication mechanism that you find on most Linux systems. And system daemons use it, and also desktop services use it. And some of these services are on a system bus, like your systemd init process is on the system bus. And other services, like, for example, your clipboard will be on a per-user login session bus. So these services expose their functionality as objects, and each object is identified by a path. And those objects implement interfaces, and the interfaces provide methods, properties, and signals. So it's a pretty object-oriented model. This library I'm using, so I'm maintaining this fork of Dbus Sharp, which has been around for a lot of time. And I updated the library to use the .NET asynchronous programming models, so task, await, async type of things. And I built a tool for generating C-sharp interfaces to access Dbus services. So the code for this is on GitHub, and packages are published on nuget.org, so you can easily consume those. It's demo time. So creating a directory here and launching Visual Studio Code. And let me open up the terminal here and create a new console project. So I get two files. One is my Hello World main file, and the other one is a project file. I'm going to make one change here, which is specifying I want the latest C-sharp version available in my program. So to interact with Dbus, the first thing we're going to do is add this TMDS Dbus package. I can do that. Let me close these up. Also on the command line. And this will fetch the package from nuget.org, and it adds the latest version, which is 0.7.0, to my project file. Another thing I'm going to add is the tool package. Unlike the previous package, the first package I added is a library, so this is what the application will be using when we're running it to interact with Dbus. The second package is actually an extension for the .NET command line interface, which we can use, like for example, to generate C-sharp code to work with with those Dbus services. So I'm going to change this to .NET CLI tool reference, because this is actually what the package is meant for. I'm going to call the .NET restore command once more, so it picks up this tool. And now I get this new command, which is .NET Dbus, which is provided by that second package. And it allows me to do two things, generate code and list stuff which is on Dbus. So for example, I can do .NET Dbus list services, and that will provide me a list with all the services which are now on my user bus. And as our demo application, we're going to build a small application that takes a screenshot of the desktop and that opens that up. And to take that screenshot, we're going to use the Orc GNOME shell service which was in this list. So I'm now going to use the cogen command. I do .NET Dbus cogen service org.gnome.shell. And what this does is it goes and talks to this service and looks at introspection data. And from that introspection data, you get this file with a lot of interfaces which describe all the functionalities that are available via this service. So one of the things provided is the ability to take screenshots, and we'll be using this iScreenshot interface and call the screenshot async method to make that screenshot using that service. So in our program file, we're going to create a local object, which is a proxy for the object in the service that allows us to create a screenshot. And now I'm going to use the connection object, which is provided by the library. I'm going to the session bus, and I'm calling the create proxy method. And I'm using this interface, which was just generated for us. I need to provide two arguments here. The first argument is the name of our service, which is org gnome shell. The second argument is the path that identifies the objects within the object within the service. And to find that object, I can again use this CLI tool. So I do .net dbus list objects service org gnome shell, and I'll grab for screenshot here. And we see there is an object at this path which provides that interface. So I'm going to write the path in here, which is org gnome shell screenshot. And there we have our proxy object, and now we can just invoke that. This is an asynchronous method, so I'm going to update my main here so it becomes async compatible, and we'll call screenshot async. As a first parameter, we specify if we want to include the cursor, let's set that to true. A second parameter is do we want to flash the screen? Yeah, let's flash the screen. And as a third parameter, we specify the file name. Now we're going to look at the result, which contains two things, the file name used and whether it was successful or not. And if the result was successful, we're going to pop up this screenshot we just made on the on the desktop. And we'll use .NET's process class for that. And we'll pick the file name from the result, and we'll ask the shell, which is our GNOME shell, to open up that screenshot. And we'll also add an else statement here to get a message. In case we weren't able to make a screenshot, we'll write the message. Let's try to build this. This builds fine, and now we can run it. And voila, we saw the flash, and there's our screenshot that pops up. So I think that was pretty nice. Like in 5 minutes, we were able to generate some code and access that dbus service. So my takeaway for you is, like, if you want to access dbus services from .NET, whether it's Mono or .NET Core, whatever, you can use this library, and it becomes really easy. So we're sort of at the end of the time slot. If you have questions, you can find me after the presentation. Thank you.